Today's topic is The Stolen Bacillus by H.G. Wells. This is a story revolving around an anarchist who tries to destroy the city with the help of a bacillus, a stolen bacillus. Who is an anarchist? Let's understand this with the help of the definition. A situation or a confusion and wild behavior in which the people in a country, group or organization, etc. are not controlled by rules or laws. Basically, anarchists are people who are malicious and cynical in manner. They do not understand and respect the level of humanity around. They hate humanity and indeed like to float death in order to this. So let's understand the summary of this. A man with pale grey eyes. Now, a man with pale grey eyes and a haggard look, that means an unwell and a pale, worn-off look, visits a bacteriologist. Now, he forges a letter and visits him with a wrong identity. Bacteriologist, out of his boosting nature, goes up into his laboratory and shows him a lot of other viruses. Now, he shows him a different kind of virus which can help destroying the world. He boastfully and trying to show off to his visitor says it to him that people who are building nuclear bombs and stuff to destroy people is something that is not required. There are more deadlier and disastrous creations of science that can even create a bad effect on mankind. So moving on, a glass tube now where to be found. After getting all the information from the bacteriologist, the man with pale grey eyes steals away the bacteria, that is bacillus, and the test tube from his laboratory. Eventually, he starts moving out into the city and there is a chase happening. The bacteriologist is actually following the anarchist, and bacteriologist's wife is following bacteriologist. Now there is a whole run in the city of London. Color of the face changes. Now as soon as the bacteriologist reaches the city, the town walls, and the anarchist is traveling in the cab, he moves out and he sees that the test tube is broken. To show himself and become a martyr in life, the man himself drinks the rest of the bacillus. And in return, what the bacteriologist sees, and there is a twist in the story that we'll understand after giving a brief look at the summary. Alright, The Stolen Bacillus by H.G. Wells is a satiric short story about the potential dangers posed by the world of science. Satire is using humor or wit as a form of ridicule which exposes flaws or faults in mankind or his institutions. The intention must be to help improve either men or the institution. In this story, Wells is satirizing the institution of science as well as the role of anarchists in society. The atmosphere of tension and fear is created from the beginning in several ways. First, of course, is the consistent mention of the dread word cholera. Just the word conjures up images of death, horrible suffering, and the plague. We are afraid of what might happen, even though the bacteriologist assures us that these specimens have been stained and killed and are therefore no longer dangerous. Now here in this situation, the storyteller is trying to explain us that no matter how the bacteriologist convinces us that all the bacteria and the germs have been killed eventually, but we still are getting a dreadful impact or images right from the beginning of the chapter wherein the word cholera is used, because cholera is being imposed as the other word of death. Moving on. Second, the mysterious visitor to the lab is consistently described as the pale-faced man, something which conjures a mystery of danger and intrigue. Third, the deadly virus is being kept in a tube which keeps readers just a little breathless with anticipation, because we know a little glass tube can easily be broken or stolen, and both things eventually do happen. Fourth, we begin to see a transformation in the pale-faced man as we see a gleam in his eyes, as he becomes more and more mesmerized by the sight of the deadly bacteria in the tube. Devouring the little tube with his eyes, it is specially chilling when he begins to recite the litany of ways in which the deadly virus might be silently transmitted to every person and animal around. The more he talks, the more we know that is not only something he has given much thought to, but it is something he almost anticipates within delight. So, here we are trying to talk about what happens in the second segment of the story, where a mysterious man who has been constantly referred as the pale-faced man, which another symbolizes us a mystery of danger and intrigue, moves on and steals away the bacteria in the test tube from the laboratory. Now we need to understand the readers are under high level of anticipation throughout the story, because a little glass tube can easily be broken or stolen, and this is what eventually happens in the plot. Moving on, only break such a little tube as this into supply of drinking water and death. Mysterious, untraceable death, death swift and terrible, death full of pain and indignity.